video, I'm going to discuss about the binomial nomenclature. We all know that the earth is very diverse and there are number of plants and animals exist on earth. Therefore, there is a need to identify these different types of organisms and to name them. The naming of these different types of organisms is called nomenclature. Firstly, let's talk about the vernacular names, which is also called as the local names. Generally, we call these different plants and animals with different local names. We can take an example of the sweet potato. Generally, we call it a sweet potato in English, but there are different names for the sweet potato, like shakarkand in Hindi and ratalu in Marathi. As we identify any new species or any new organism, it's really important to name it with a very fixed and a scientific name so that it won't be confusing for us. Because these local names are too confusing. Though they are easy to remember, easy to write, but still they are confusing. Because in the different regions of the world, people generally call these different plants and animals with different names. So we could not identify these different types of organism with this regional or the local names. That's why we need the binomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature is the system of nomenclature or the system of naming of different organisms. The binomial system of nomenclature generally introduced by the Carlos Linnaeus. He was a Swedish naturalist. He introduced this system in his book called Species Plantarum in 1753. So what does mean the binomial name? So binomial name or the binomial nomenclature consists of two words or the parts or the epithets. First one is the generic name and the second one is the specific name. This is a very important part of the binomial system, that it contains the generic name and the specific name. Though it contains the two words, that's why it's called as the binomial system. Then there is a universal rules of the nomenclature. The universal rule means they are accepted universally. So if you have been identified any new organism or a species, you should follow all these rules to name them properly. So first rule is that the biological names are in Latin or the Greek language and it should be written in the italic form. This is one of the very important rule of the binomial system. Another rule for the binomial system is that its first name always be a genus name. And the second name is called a specific name or the specific epithet. When you write the binomial name with your hand, or it's called a handwritten, then you should underline the binomial name or the scientific name. The genus name or the genus part start with the capital letter and the specific name start with the small letter. We can take an example of the Mangifera indica, which is a scientific name for the mango. So here you can see the genus name starts with the capital M and the small letter I is for the specific name. So specific name is starting with the small letter and the genus name is starting with the capital M letter. Name of the author appears after the specific epithet. For example, Mangifera indica, Linn, which stands for the Linnaeus. And the generic as well as the specific name does not generally have less than 3 letters and more than 13 letters. This rule is because as you name any new species or new organism, so you should be remember that its name should not be less than the 3 letters and should not more than the 13 letters. It is also one of the important rules. We can take certain examples like Mangifera indica, which is scientific name for the mango, Azadi recta indica, which is a scientific name for the neem, and the Helianthus annus, which is scientific name for the sunflower. Now it is important that indica, here it is also indica. So there is a one point regarding to the binomial system, is that the name, the genus name and the specific name, maximum time it depends on the morphology or the origin or the different characteristics of that organism. For example, here it has written as a Mangifera indica and Mangifera Azadi recta indica because their origin for the mango and name is India. That's why they have given the name as Mangifera indica and Azadi recta indica. We can also take an example of the Mycobacterium. It is a kind of a bacteria, but its genus name is Mycobacterium because myco is related to fungus. So wherever you see the myco, it's always related to fungus. We all know that mycology, that is the study of fungus, it's called mycology. So we have named this bacteria with the Mycobacterium because it shows morphology similar to fungus. That's why it has genus name as Mycobacterium. So this genus name and species name always related to different characteristics like the morphological, anatomical, physiological, biochemical characteristics of that organism, their origin, or even though on the basis of the person who has identified them at the very first time. So these are the certain points regarding to the binomial nomenclature. That is, it is introduced by the Carlos Linnaeus. It consists two words, genus and the specific name. It should be written in the italic form. The genus name should be first and the specific name should be second. When you are handwritten, when you have writing it with your hand, it should be underlined. The genus name should be start with the capital letter and the specific name should be start with the small letter. These are the certain very important points of the binomial system which you should remember while writing the different scientific names of the different organism. Okay guys, so this is all about the binomial nomenclature system. I hope you will understand this and it will be clear to you. If you like, so please share, subscribe. Thank you so much.